being the first woman to be a program manager of ships in the history of the Navy. But, you know, the big thing that launched the career, you know, converting the process that was on paper of 2 years to draw a rough draft of a ship into using her computer program to 18 hours and 26 minutes. What you're looking at is the Meritorious Civilian Service Award that she was given, which is the third highest honor in the U.S. Navy. And so she received that for revolutionizing the way ships are designed. And what's interesting is that some of her ships, she designed the first ship of a class of ships. So she built the mold, and then they build more of them based on that. And she designed all types of ships. Some of her ships are still at sea, and she took such great pride in knowing that the work that she was doing to help was helping to protect sailors and Marines, and that was really important to her.
And this woman who felt like her story didn't matter wound up on Good Morning America to tell people what she did. She's the Navy's hidden figure. My literary agent saw her, smelled an irresistible story in the making, and reached out to David and his mother about making that happen. I was connected with the family next, and I guess you could say in more ways than one, the rest is history.
She was a product of the Jim Crow South. You know, she was someone that defied the odds as her mother, Flossie McNeil, told her even as a child that she had to remember she had three strikes against her. She's from the segregated South. There are stereotypes about the South. And of course, she was a woman or a girl at the time. And then that she was also a minority, a Black person. And those three strikes come at her from different angles all throughout her career. But as long as she worked hard to education and try to make the best decision she could, that she would overcome and achieve her dreams. And it was important for her to open doors for other people at the same time.